I'm Yu Watanabe from University of Tokyo. I'll talk about my presentation, Summer Real Scholarship of Dark Matter. This talk is based on this paper. At first, I'll talk about the motivation and the model of real scholarship and explain several constraints, including Landau-Pohl, relic abundance, collider, direct detection, and indirect detection. Finally, I'll summarize the results. Summer dark matter is a dark matter candidate which experiences equilibrium with standard model particle in the early universe. Among them, dark matter candidate with electron weak sized mass and interaction is called WIMP. With these parameters, WIMP can explain the observed dark matter density by freeze-out mechanism. This fact is called WIMP miracle, and with this attractive feature, WIMP is being intentionally searched for. However, uncharted type of WIMP still exist, and one of them is eWIMP. eWIMP is electron weakly charged WIMP expressed as an SSL multiplet, and this can be classified as this table. DD and LP represent the constraint from direct detection and Landau-Pohl. Fermion triplet is known as we know, quintuplet known as minimal dark matter. Scalar doublet is known as inner doublet model, and they have been studied very much until now. However, scalar triplet is not very much studied yet, so we comprehensively studied it, concretely find the parameter region surviving from the constraints. The renormalizable and gauge invariant Lagrangian of the scalar triplet model is defined as this. Chi is scalar triplet and Kaiser plays the role of dark matter. This is the kinetic term of Chi, and this is the interaction between Chi and Higgs doublet, and self-interaction of Chi. At tree level, Chi plus minus and Chi zero are degenerate in mass. However, one loop correction breaks this degeneracy and make Chi plus minus slightly heavier than Chi zero, 166 MeV. And there are three free parameters, dark matter mass m chi, lambda chi h, and lambda chi. However, lambda chi is not important for the phenomenology, and phenomenology is governed by lambda chi h and m chi. So I'll calculate the constraint to these two parameters. At first, I'll talk about constraint from Landau-Pohl. These diagrams these diagrams make lambda chi run fast, so the theory may break down below high energy. By solving the renormalization group equations with two loop beta functions, the parameter region in which Landau-Pohl does not appear up to high energy scale is this figure. Shaded region is excluded. For example, if we insist that Landau-Pohl does not appear up to 10 to 14 GeV, lambda chi h should be less than 0.5. Next, I'll talk about relic abundance. Relic abundance can be obtained by solving Boltzmann equations. In solving, there are two effects to consider. Due to the strong degeneracy between chi plus minus and chi zero in mass, coannihilation process is important. In other words, besides the two-body state, chi zero, we should consider the other two body states like chi plus chi zero or chi plus chi plus. And when dark matter is much heavier than standard model particles, Sommerfeld effect is important. This is non-perturbative effect of long-range force induced by exchanging standard model bosons. In a language of diagrams, this can be understood as summing all radar diagrams like this. Sommerfeld effect enhances the annihilation cross-section, and from this figure, we can find that Sommerfeld effect reduces the abundance compared to the three-level calculation. The result is in this figure. Shaded region is triplet. The shaded region is excluded because the scalar triplet is overabundant. The region on the edge is WIMP miracle one, on which the summary relic of scalar triplet explains the observed dark matter density. And Unshaded region is under abundant, and in this region, we can consider two scenarios. Scenario one, preplate contributes in part to the observed dark matter density, and other parts is from other dark matter candidates, like axions. And scenario two, triplate explains the full dark matter, observed dark matter density by non-thermal process. I'll calculate constraints to these two scenarios. Finally, I'll talk about experiments. There are three types of experiments, collider, indirect detection, and direct detections. In collider, disappearing track search is known as the most efficient one. This search is the track of chi plus minus decaying into chi zero and soft pion. Due to the strong generality between chi plus minus and chi zero, chi plus minus becomes a long-lived particle and leaves the order 1 centimeter track, which can be reconstructed in HE. And indirect detection observes the standard model particle produced by annihilation of dark matter in the universe. As observed standard model particles, gamma ray is efficient, and as a target in which dark matter annihilates, dwarf spheroid galaxies are efficient. And Fermilat and CTA are most stringent at present and in the near future. In direct detection, direct detection observes the scattering between dark matter and nucleon. This scattering can be described by effective interaction between dark matter and quark gluon. These diagrams induce the leading contribution. However, when the coupling constant of this vertex, lambda chi h, is suppressed, these two diagrams become important, and these diagrams induce these two operators. Xenon 1 ton and xenon n ton are most stringent at present and in the near future. The solid line corresponds to the constraint from xenon 1 ton and xenon n ton. The region above the line is excluded. And the dotted line corresponds from top to lambda chi h is 0.5, 0.25, and lambda chi h is 0. And on the blue line, lambda chi h is adjusted so that WIMP miracle occurs. In other words, on this line, thermal relic of real scalar triplet can explain observed dark matter density. From this figure, we can find that xenon 1 ton cannot constrain WIMP miracle region. However, xenon n ton can constrain almost all of the WIMP miracle region, except for
two minutes more.
Thank you. Xenon n ton can constrain almost all of the WIMP miracle region, except for this tiny region. The constraints mentioned above summarized in these figures. The left panel corresponds to the case where triplet contributes in part to the observed dark matter density, and the right panel corresponds to the case where triplet explains the full dark matter density. Shaded regions are excluded at present experiments, and DD and ID and LP correspond to the direct detection, indirect detection, and random pole, respectively. The P and F represent present and near future, respectively. From these figures, we can find that WIMP miracle region and dark matter mass of about 3.5 TeV is surviving from the experience at present. And light green lines shows the constant from direct detection in the near future, xenon n ton. And the line above, the region above this line will be constrained by xenon n ton. So from these figures, we can find that xenon n ton can constrain almost all of the parameter region. In summary, real scalar triplet is an attractive dark matter candidate, so we comprehensively studied it. And miracle region is still surviving from constraints at present. Finally, such region can be effectively searched for by near future experiments, especially xenon n ton. Thank you for listening.